Hey guys, welcome back to TFC True Fans Chat. My name is Michael, and as always, I'm with the incredible Eddie and the amazing Carl. How are you guys doing today? Eddie, how are you?
I'm doing all right, man. I'm doing all right. I'm buzzing. TFC won. TFC advances to the finals.
That's right.
It's a good week.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, definitely. And Carl, how are you doing today?
I'm fantastic. Thank you so much for having me back on the show.
No problem. Yeah, that's why we do this. Because like, TFC is the boss. Like right now, TFC has got to win two games and they can consider themselves the champions of North America, I guess. North America and like Central America, right? Because we're in the finals.
Yeah.
Like what the frick? Like Eddie, could you have seen this like 5 years ago, like when you first started TFC as a fan? Like what the hell, right?
No, not even close.
Yeah, like,
not even close. It's been a good ride so far. I'm happy about everything that's going on with the team.
Yeah,
you know, it's a good time to be a TFC fan for sure.
Yeah,
yeah.
Like honestly, like me, I've only really started watching them when kind of Giovinco started. So you can call me kind of like a bandwagoner, I guess, bandwagoner. But but Carl, you've been with the team, I guess, like even before Giovinco, right? Like when did you start being a fan?
I don't remember the year, but I do remember the feeling when we finally won a game. that was like winning the championship right there.
Yeah, for sure. Those are dark times, yeah. Oh my gosh. But yeah, so today we're going to be talking about a lot of the CONCACAF Champions League, obviously, because you know we're still in it. We did the last MLS team in it. New York Red Bulls lost in semifinals, so we're not going to be playing them. We're going to be playing another Mexican team, which we'll go over later on. We'll talk about playing Colorado on Saturday. And also, like, just the state of the team. Like, where are we? Kind of, how are we doing so far? We won our first. No, did we win our first? Well, we beat RSL, Real Salt Lake, last 2 weeks ago, was it, or something like that? That was a good win. We're getting points right now. I don't know. Did you guys see the MLS standings? Like, we're like what? What place are we in? Like,
I haven't checked.
Yeah. I think we're still like second last.
But yeah, probably.
Honestly, so we haven't played as many games as other people.
Yeah.
And at least we have some points on there.
Yeah, it's true.
Like, if you look at New York City, they're like steamrolling. I think they, I don't know if, I think they've maybe lost one game or tied a game, but they're winning the games.
Yeah.
So we have something to catch up to if we want to win, like the Supporters Shield.
And we have a catcher for a reason. He's going to do some catching up once he gets going.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. All right. Let's get into some of this this last game we had against Club America. What do you, from that game, like, it was stressful, eh? Like, what would you say?
It was unreal. Okay, first off, the first leg, we should probably talk about that.
Yeah,
true. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. The fact that, like, we were dominating that game.
Yeah.
It's like, who is this team, you know?
Yeah.
I can't believe it. I'm so proud of what we achieved.
Yeah.
And not only that, going away and still almost coming away with a win. Are you kidding me?
I know, eh? Like, it is unbelievable. And what's pretty cool, too, is that a lot of Canadian players, you can see that a lot of Canadian players on Toronto FC are getting time and playing minutes.
Yeah.
Like, I could specifically, I want to give a really good, like, congrats to Ashton Morgan, because I didn't...
He's been fantastic.
Yeah. Like, he's done really well, and like watching that last game, he's gone a long way.
He's been with Toronto for so long that even guys coming in like out the door, they care more about getting respect from guys like Morgan and Osorio than some other guys because, A, they're like Canadian, right? But they've just been here so long and know all about the club. Seeing him performing the way he is now, that's just Amazing.
Yeah, for sure. And then you have like Osorio, like he's been gifted with, well, not gifted, but like he's able to score goals. Actually, he's, well, I'm not gonna say he's leading in the well, he's tied in the leader for the most goals in the CONCACAF Champions League this year. It's not really a big thing because so are five other people with three goals. So, but what's cool to note, actually, yeah, we can mention it now, actually. What's cool to note is that Osorio and Jovinko both have three goals in the Champions League. They're the only two players who have three goals that are in the finals. So there are no Chivas players that have three goals. There are two Chivas players that have two goals. So technically, I don't know if there's like a golden boot or like some kind of award for the most goals in this tournament. But yeah. But Osorio and Jovinko have a chance to kind of claim that kind of honor. You know, it's pretty cool. Canadian guy.
It's definitely cool.
Yeah.
The fact that Osorio scored in the same place where Maradona was playing World Cups. Yeah, yeah. Right. You know.
Yeah, that's all right. Yeah. And this is coming from a guy who like was ripping on Osorio, and I'm sure Carl, you can attest to this. Like, I was ripping on Osorio last at least 2 years. I was like, dude, this guy has to like stop playing. You know, he's got to like let other guys play. You know, like he has to be on the bench and stuff like that. But yeah, this year he's definitely his turn his best. I would say it's early, but like one of his best years so far. Well, I never really watched him when he was younger, but I'm not sure he was probably not this good, right, guys? I don't know. Actually, yeah, I was looking at the goal from that Osorio scored in this past game, the 1-1 draw against Club America. And I thought originally that Ricketts passed it, but then I saw like the close-up replay. It was actually a defender who stuck his leg and kicked the ball away from Ricketts, and it just landed right in front of Osorio. So honestly, that was a bit not lucky, but like let's say we're fortunate to have that goal. Yeah.
That's unbelievable. Yeah. I had no idea.
Yeah, Ricketts. Like, what do you guys think about Ricketts that game?
Oh, he played amazing, actually. Yeah, he played really well. You know, came off the bench for Altidore when Altidore got injured, and he put in a good shift and. Sadly, he was subbed off at the end. I don't know why he was, but he should have stayed on. And I think if he stayed on, would have probably scored another goal. And he had a really good game. Semi assisted Osorio's goal, but you know, it doesn't matter.
It's funny to say that because I kind of don't agree completely. I do agree that he went on and he got the job done. He got the goal, even though it sounds like it might have been a bit lucky. What I feel is lacking, though, holding possession of that ball. You know how, like, Altidore is real big. He's able to, like, hold up the play, keep possession a little bit more. It felt like we'd clear the ball, and that's it. It'd just be hammered because we're not able to keep that possession up top at all.
Yeah.
So, in one sense, he's not that kind of player, and I feel like that's what you're gonna talk about. So go for it, Mike.
Yeah, I feel like he has like a more too much of a similar role to Jovinko because they're both kind of they like to dribble and they're not really physical and they're kind of I guess they have some like a bit of pace, and so I feel like with him subbing on for Hamilton, I was thinking that would be a good substitution, but I didn't think Vanny would actually do it just because I never seen a person being subbed on, being subbed off again. I don't know if you guys seen that ever. And like, I don't watch too many soccer games maybe, but it's not a common thing, right?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it happens when players get injured, right?
Okay.
Yeah. And he started early in the game. So it's not like he was on for 10 minutes and got taken off.
True. So. Yeah, that's true. Okay, yeah. So, any other thoughts about that game against Club America? Should we head over?
Overall, team got the job done. Yeah. That's all we care about. Yeah.
Vanderweel got subbed off halfway at halftime because of a potential injury. Still questionable for next games.
That's tough because he's playing amazing in that center back role. Like, honestly, I'd rather he just sticks to that role than go back on the wing. The team is just amazing with him there.
All right, so yeah, hopefully he gets back into shape and continue to do that. Speaking of actually center backs, Jason Hernandez, the defender that was signed for TFC last year, who played like a handful of games. I think he was a decent center back. There were rumors about him being signed because of you know, all of these injuries of like Moore and Gregory Vanderweel now. Although that was the rumor was before he got injured. But anyways, Mavinga, sorry. So I don't know where that rumor came from, or I know where it came from, but like I don't know where it went. You know, I don't think we signed it.
Yeah. I think it's a good idea considering the games we have coming up and the guys that we don't have. He knows our system. He knows what his role would be. So ideally, yeah, you want to sign maybe someone younger, someone who you can build with the team even further. But he's still got that experience. He can come in and start almost right away if we need him to, right? Yeah,
he's like one of those. He'd be like a player trainer, you know? Like pushing them to do better and kind of bringing that mentality of work your ass off to get things done, which I think is great.
Yeah, for sure.
All right, so let's head over to the next. Let's talk about Chivas Guadalajara. We beat Club America, and now we're heading on to the finals against Chivas Guadalajara. And let me tell you, this is one of the, okay, besides Colorado, because we all knew we were going to be Colorado. Like, let's not kid ourselves. No. But like against Tigres, Club America, I always went into it being like, oh my gosh, like we might lose and we might lose badly if we don't, like, you know, get our game going. I was always nervous about it. But this against Chivas Guadalajara, they're not doing the greatest in Champions League and even in their league, their own like Liga MX. Like I'm going to throw out some numbers for you guys. So Tigres and Club America, they are both currently third and fourth in their league, which is there's 18 teams. So that's pretty good, right? And we beat those teams. We beat those, both of them, right? Chivas are 15th of 18th place. So like I'm going to say, let's not be overconfident, but it seems like there's less stress now, you know, there's less of a worry. What do you guys think? Eddie, what do you think? Do you think that it's going to be like a walk through the park, or is this going to be like a crazy, like two-leg, freaking crazy game, like tight match?
I think it would be a crazy tight match. Obviously, we have the, we played the first leg here in Toronto.
Right.
So, like, I mean, so far, like with our experience at home with Mexican teams, we've been solid so far. You know, the fans have really gone behind the players, and the players have really showed up and you know, played well. So I expect is you know, it kind of like a similar first leg at home, you know, and then with, you know, Toronto pressing, you know, trying to score as much goals as possible. And I think it will be, you know, slightly difficult when we go back to Guadalajara to play Chivas.
Right, but like I mean, we already played in the volcano, whatever they call it, in Monterrey for Tigres. We played in the Azteca Stadium, which is like the biggest stadium in Mexico. So honestly, like going to Guadalajara, it's like been there, done that kind of thing in terms of like something that
I mean, like,
scale.
We've played in like two of the hardest stadiums in Mexico, like the Estadio Aztecas is is really high. It has like and you know, you have to be like really fit to be able to like play a full 90 minutes there, right?
But you're worried about playing Guadalajara.
I mean, like, I'm just saying, like, you know, with the way our experiences have been this season with Mexican teams, second leg has always been like let's just defend and like
I don't know. I feel like against Tigres we definitely like were trying to be attacking, like especially when we played against Tigres in the volcano thing, the volcano place. I feel like we were very attacking. That's why I kind of scored like those two goals, right? And we needed goals. Carl, what do you think about this upcoming series against Chivas?
First off, I know that a lot of people are probably hoping we'll be playing New York Red Bulls, but having this game, it just makes it so much more exciting. It's going to attract the world instead of just like, oh, another like MLS matchup, you know? So that's first off. Second off, I get what both of you are saying, where against Tigres, we did attack more. But you got to remember, think of all these injuries and players missing from our lineup, right? I think if Altidore stayed on, would have been a totally different game. Who knows? Maybe we could have totally dominated. I don't know. That said, also, going forward against Chivas, who knows what the lineup is going to look like? We are missing guys, but the guys that are coming in, they're really stepping up. So it's a true underdog story, you know?
Yeah. I mean, you have Ashton Morgan playing well. Auro was good. I guess Bradley was his normal self doing well, although that penalty at the end was kind of unnecessary. But
do you know who's injured right now?
Yes. So Altidor, obviously, and Gregory Vanderweil both left the game, so they're questionable. That's the last I heard of them. Vasquez, Moro, and Bavinga are kind of coming out of their injury, so it's not yet known whether they'll play against Colorado on Saturday, but yeah, good to see them back.
Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah.
And how about cards?
Oh, yeah.
I've heard in this tournament, it's so confusing. The cards still carry over into the finals or something like that. So not only do we have injuries, but we got, I don't know how many guys with cards, but yeah.
Yeah, no, I got it right here. It's we got six players with one yellow card. And they only need one more to miss the second leg of the final. And that's Jozy Altidore, Michael Bradley, Sebastian Giovinco. Those are our three DPs right there, right? Drew Moore, Jonathan Osorio, and Victor Vasquez.
So, like, if they get a card in the MLS game, does that affect them in the CONCACAF?
No.
Totally independent, yeah. Which is a good thing. Obviously, yeah. I can see definitely someone getting a yellow card in the first leg. Hopefully not, because I feel like it will get heated. Especially Jozy Altidore, you know how he is. He likes to get into like people's faces and all that.
Yeah. Let's hope he plays. First off, injury. Who knows? Yeah.
True.
We got against us, yeah.
True.
Maybe he can start. Maybe he will start just in case. Yellow card.
Hopefully. I don't know what his injury is and how bad it was, but it didn't look too bad. Like, he was able to walk off and everything. So hopefully soon he will be back. So let's see. So we are the third MLS team to reach the final, which is also a feat in itself. Real Salt Lake reached back in like 2011 or something like that. Montreal Impact, the crappy team in Montreal, is also made at one time. But no one obviously won it. So this is our chance as a MLS representative kind of to win it. And honestly, I'm feeling good about it.
Yeah.
No doubt. And I think only LA won it before, but the whole format of it changed now too.
Yeah.
So it's going to be totally unique to anything that's happened before, if we win it, obviously.
Yeah. We shouldn't be overconfident, although... it's not be overconfident, but like after these past two series where we're like, well, at least I was personally like, you know, I don't know if we're gonna win. It's like now it's like, screw this, we're gonna win, of course.
We're gonna win.
Yeah.
We're gonna barbecue some boats.
Chivas is like I watched a game against Chivas in New York Red Bulls. Man, New York Red Bulls suck, okay? They can't even score against them. Like I mean, they didn't score. They didn't score.
It was 0-0. It was 1-0 in the end overall.
Yeah. And so it's like and they were doing okay. Like New York Red Bulls are doing okay, but Chivas was doing really bad. Like they're not the best. And obviously in the league they're not doing the best too. It's also nice to note that Chivas has like a rule. I think it's a rule that they only sign Mexican players. And they're a huge, huge club. Like they're the biggest, most followed club in all of Mexico. So I wouldn't be surprised if a bunch of them came out to Toronto's game because there's a lot of Mexicans, obviously, in Canada. There are some. A lot of them came out against Tigres when we played against Tigres, and I think Club America as well, to the BMO field. So
they're basically the second national team of Mexico. So exactly. Honestly, this is fantastic for TFC just to get exposure. You know, it's going to be such a big game.
Yeah, for sure. And well, we won't get ahead of ourselves, but like if they win, it's like, you know, we have a chance to play against international teams, which is like pretty cool.
No doubt.
Yeah. All right. So let's head on to our next topic of today, which is our game against Colorado on Saturday. So we had a bye week from MLS last weekend, which was good because we have Club America, so we kind of focus on that. Now we're going to have before the Chivas game, we have Colorado, and in between the Chivas games, we have Houston, both away games. So, yeah, but let's focus on Colorado because Houston's later on. But Colorado, we've played them before. In the first round of the CONCACAF. I think it's a big difference now, though, because they had a new coach back then. They have they signed some players since then. And now they're more familiar with the coach, what the coach wants and all that. So I feel like it's not going to be as easy as it was. I mean, we didn't destroy them in the first round of the CONCACAF Champions League. But it was early in the season, so we were kind of rusty. And now we're like, you know, really good, or at least better. Right, better chemistry. So, what do you guys think, Carl? What do you think about we should win this one, no doubt, right?
Well, what I've heard from what I read, Vanny said he's going to leave a lot of like the big guys out of this game. So we're going to see a lot of the subs, the guys who haven't had as many hours coming in and playing that game. And to be honest, with the injuries, great thing. They get a bit more experience with that high altitude, get their fitness up, and get a touch on the ball, get ready to go, you know?
Mm-hmm. Who do you think out of all the people that haven't really played much this season, whether MLS or CONCACAF Champions League, who will be starting?
Definitely Hamilton is probably excited to get a start, because I heard Giovinco and Altidore are going to kind of rest on this one. I could definitely see a catcher coming in. In my eyes, he has so much potential, so I really hope this is kind of where he kind of picks up the pace and gets going, you know?
Right. Ed, how about Jordan? You? Who do you think is who do you think will we see starting who hasn't really gotten a lot of playing time this season?
To be honest, I'm not quite sure.
Fair enough.
Again, in the past two games, I've played really well, so I expect him to start in the next game too himself.
Right. That's true.
Yeah, it's hard to say.
It is, yeah.
Maybe like some young stars from TFC2, they will come in and they'll, you know.
Like that guy, the American guy, Akinyola, I think his name is.
Yeah, you signed him.
The guy that's supposed to be like. Maybe.
I could also see Jay Chapman.
He's one
of those guys. But...
I was going to say Jay Chapman. I don't think you started this year ever, or even but did he even play at all?
He's been subbed on, but not started. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I wanted to mention that. Yeah, so Greg Vanny. I was gonna say Gregory Vanderbilt, but yeah. Greg Vanny said that he's kind of gonna rest those who need rest and play those who don't need the rest. Basically, he mentioned that a lot of guys will get an opportunity to play that haven't been getting the opportunity. So when we look at like the players that need rest, I can still see Jovinko kind of play. Like, it's surprising, but I don't think he's pretty he's a lot of stamina. Like, I can see him playing in Saturday's game. He doesn't like missing games. He loves to play, right? Like, he gets pissed off when he's subbed off and all that. So I see him playing. Altidore probably is not going to play because even the precautionary in case maybe if he's injured. So I can see like Jovinko, Hamilton up front, Chapman in the middle, Akeche probably. I can see. Well, I don't know who would be tired. I guess the old people. Bradley. Bradley never really misses a game.
Oh, Bradley is not going to miss it.
We'll see.
Yeah, exactly. That's not going to be in Toronto, though. So if anyone else want to watch it, it has to be on TV, which is pretty cool. Good, I guess. that's all we have, really. Did you guys want to add anything before we end this?
Go TFC, go. Let's go. Let's win this.
Yeah.
Let's show the Mexican teams that we ain't no joke.
That's right.
I mean, we're already shooting two of them. Let's show the powerhouse one more. We ain't no joke. We're here to win the Champions League. And we're going to play in the FIFA Club World Cup, play against big boys like Ronaldo and stuff like that, you know? It is what it is. CFC, here we go.
That's right. Let's get past these goats and then dominate MLS, you know?
That's right. New York City should be shaking in their fake roof. Soccer field of a baseball field they have. So Colorado and TFC playing on Saturday. Make sure everyone watches that because that's going to be amazing. And obviously buy tickets for the game against Chivas Guadalajara. That's going to be insane. I can't go because I'm in the middle of nowhere, but I'm sure you guys
can. I can't go. I got exams.
Well, we'll be watching. We'll be sitting down on the couch and cheering on for our Reds. All right. I want to thank you guys for coming on. I want to thank whoever is watching this that they're watching this. And if you like it, make sure you click the like button. If you want to watch more, make sure you click the subscribe button. If you like bells, make sure you click the bell button. I heard that's fun. it doesn't make a noise, but you can still press it.
You can make a noise if you want. Ding dong.
Yeah, I'll make it for you. Oh, thank you. All right. Thanks, guys, for coming on, and we'll see you next time.
Take care.
See ya.